Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back to the Faith Revival. So last time we talked about major sins, how forgiving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is if a person repents and they die in that state of repentance as opposed to maintaining those major sins or insisting on them. Now, one thing that the Prophet told us is that iman does increase and decrease. We find this in many different narrations. It's something that we find in the Quran, لِيَزْدَادُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِيمَانًا, that people of faith would be increased in their faith, أَيُّكُمْ زَادَتُ هَذِي إِيمَانًا, which of you was increased in faith by this, يَزِيدُ اللَّهُ, so the idea of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increasing a person in guidance, all of these different verses exist. This is something that's well established, that faith does increase and decrease. However, I want you to imagine your heart in the spiritual sense. If you're looking at the line and it's just straight, that means you're dead. That means nothing is happening. But if the fluctuation is too crazy, it's also unhealthy. How is your spiritual heart beating? If you could graph it out, is it doing this or is it doing this? All right, or is it doing this? And do you have no idea what I'm talking about? Because that's a possibility as well. But it should be just like your physical heart, just like this. Right? Where sometimes it's here, 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 but it always comes down to that same point. It doesn't die. So there are healthy, natural fluctuations in faith. Even the companions of the Prophet ﷺ had those fluctuations. Every single human being. There is no way that your iman can be the same all the time, everywhere that you are. There's no way that after Ramadan, your iman will be the same as it was inside Ramadan, or that your iman in the masjid is the same as it is outside the masjid. However, what you have to make sure is that when you're outside of those ideal environments, you don't undermine or undo all of the work that you've done in those good environments. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us this beautiful, powerful example. Actually using something that the companions saw in Mecca, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّتِي نَقَدَتْ غَزْلَهَا, do not be like the woman who undid her knot after it was strong. مِن بَعْدِ قُوَّةٍ أَنْكَاثَ, after it was very strong and established. There was a woman in Mecca that used to, she's referred to as a woman that used to, put together knots, and she used to sew. And then after she would put it all together and it was a strong knot, she would go there and then untie everything that she did. She would undo all of her work. And the companions used to see her, and people used to call her a madwoman. Why do you put all that effort into sewing and tying these knots, and then as soon as you get there to a strong point, you then undo it all and then you start over the next day? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, don't be like that woman with your oaths. The oaths that you make to Allah, the promises you make to Him, and the promises that you make to the people. Don't undo your good work in times where you have low faith or in times where you're not reaching your optimal performance. So for some people, that depression of iman can be unhealthy because I set unrealistic standards for myself. So I try to dive in all at one time. Like I've been this far away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so I need to hurry up and get it all together at one time. So I try to do everything all at once, and it's just gonna collapse one day because I'm not building on a firm foundation. For some people, it's not that when I don't reach my optimal performance, it all collapses. It's that when I sin horribly, and when I do good deeds, I do amazing good deeds, which we said iman is meant to be second, it's meant to be settled. So it can't be that crazy. So the Prophet ﷺ, he tells us, إِنَّ لِكُلِّ عَمَلٍ شِرَّةٍ, that every action has its peak. وَلِكُلِّ شِرَّةٍ فَتْرَةٍ, and every peak has its low point. فَمَنْ كَانَتْ شِرَّتُهُ إِلَى سُنَّتِي فَقَدْ اهْتَدَى, so whoever has their peak in accordance with my sunnah is guided. وَمَنْ كَانَتْ فَتْرَتُهُ, and whoever's low point is to other than that, إِلَى غَيْرِ ذَلِكْ فَقَدْ هَلَكْ, then he has perished, then he will lose everything. What the Prophet ﷺ is telling us is that our peak has to be reasonable and our low point. He emphasized the crashing point, the low point in iman. Why? Because if I prayed Qiyam al-Layl for 200 days of the year, but then I stop praying for 20 days of the year, even my 5 daily prayers, all that Qiyam goes to waste. The Prophet ﷺ says, "Bayn al-kufri wal iman as-salah." What is between belief and disbelief is the prayer. So if I'm doing amazing things in Ramadan, but then I completely neglect it after that, what's the point? Where did it go? I'm just undoing this strong knot that I had. So the Prophet ﷺ emphasized the low point, not the high point. Allah won't punish you if you're not doing extra voluntary good deeds. Allah will only hold you accountable to your obligations. Allah wants you to maintain steadiness. So he emphasizes the low point. What is my low point? What is my fatra? My fatra has to be at the bare minimum that I continue to perform my obligations, that I continue to perform my obligations, that I continue to avoid major sins, and I don't insist on minor sins. If all I want to do is just pray my five prayers, and don't ever underestimate, get back to basics, don't ever underestimate how valuable it is to Allah that you're just praying your five prayers. Sometimes your iman has to be on autopilot. That's fine. Just do that, and then when you can kick it back up into the next gear, then you kick it into the next gear, inshallah ta'ala. But never allow your crashing point, your fatra, to go to a point where you're going to undo all of the good that you have done. So the Prophet ﷺ once again said, keep your peak reasonable, so don't aim so high that it's unreasonable. And he said, ﷺ, that focus on the crash, the low point. Faith will increase and decrease, keep it healthy, keep your five prayers, keep your obligations, avoid the major sins, and do not insist on minor sins. That way your iman will remain intact until you are able to develop it and take it to the next level again, inshallah. Jazakumullahu khairan. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.